Maybe that works. Marvellous. Okay, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Even when I turn to the screen, okay?
Okay.
My name is Neil Chandler. I'm an independent consultant. And I also help out doing this sort of thing in the UK. So I help organise the UK conference like this. All right, just killing time. When you write some SQL, Oracle runs it through the optimizer to work out the best and fastest way to access your data. It takes a parse representation of your SQL statement, not your actual SQL statement, but something that looks like it, simplifies it, and plugs it into the optimizer. It goes and grabs some statistics and generates lots and lots of plans and compares them. It finds the plan with the lowest cost and it goes, that's the one we're going to use to access your data because that's the fastest way to do it. Good. Now, Oracle's weighing up a lot of information. And as of about Oracle 10 or 11, I can't remember which, the amount of guesses that it's allowed to have to work out your best plan is 2,000. Because there is a break-even point. At some point, you've got to stop guessing the best way to get the data and just go and get the data. Or you could spend longer guessing how to get it than actually going to retrieve it. So it's got to stop at some point, and that's up to 2,000 guesses. The problem with that is if you've got some complex SQL, if you've got, say, a five-table join, the amount of combinations of access paths that can happen is around 30 million. So with only 2,000 guesses available to Oracle, it's going to get it wrong. And you're probably wondering, how are there 30 million possible access paths on a five-table join? Well, first of all, you've got the join order for the tables. We can join table A to B to C to D to E. Or we can join table A to B to C to E to D. Or table A to B to E to D to C. And so on and so on, and you work that out for five tables, it's 5 factorial, 120 possible combinations. And then you've got your join methods, how are we putting the tables together, and there's 3 of those. We've got nested loops, hash joins, and merge joins. And so that's 3 between each table, that's 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, 81, multiply that by the number of permutations, we've now got 10,000 options. And then we add to that how we're actually getting to the data within the table, the actual access path. And there's a lot of these. Full table scan, index unique scan, index range scan or index scan, index skip scan, index fast full scan, bitmap conversion, star schema, bloom filter, bitmap single value access, bitmap range, bitmap index range scan, and so on. There's a lot of them, but we only really use these 5 down the end. So for convenience, there's 5. So that's 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, which is 3,000 possible ways to access the data, multiplied by the 10,000, 30 million possible access paths. That's a lot of possible access paths. We've only got 2,000 guesses. Now, it's much worse if you've got 6 tables you're joining. That's 2.7 billion possible access paths. Now, Oracle's very clever. And it does some neat tricks to work out the best way, and it throws plans away very, very quickly. But it's going to get it wrong. A complex SQL. And then, sometimes the optimizer changes its mind. And so, a piece of SQL which was running fairly quickly, suddenly doesn't run quite as quickly. Usually, we don't notice. Because it's tiny. But sometimes it's not a tiny difference. Sometimes it's a really bad day. Sometimes you spend all day trying to work out why your system is no longer working. And I'm sure that's happened to many of the people in this room. I know it has me. I've been on holiday and the office calls and says, we have a problem. So why did Oracle change the plan? What caused it be different, and how can I get the optimizer to make the right decision? And all property you want from the optimizer? Okay. So a common cause for a new SQL execution plan is you added some data to your database and you gathered stats and your plan changed because it's reoptimized it, and the main input to the reoptimization is your stats. Stats change, your plan changes. Or maybe you didn't do anything at all. You might have added some data, but you didn't change your stats, and you kept running exactly the same SQL, and then your plan changed. And let's go for demo number one, I'll show you this happening. So, I've got a nice simple table. It's got a few columns, a date column, a text column, an ID column. And I'm putting some data in there, 1,000 rows. And I do a select. It's worth noting, I'm setting a fixed date. So the date from this point is December 25th. If I do a select from the table, I get a full table scan. If I now add some more data, takes a few seconds. Slightly longer than I was expecting. So we've now added more data. We've got lots of data in the table with lots of different dates. And we run the query again. You notice I haven't gathered statistics. We get a table scan again. Table access full. It hasn't changed. But if I gather statistics and run the SQL again, we've now got a new plan because the data changed, the statistics changed, the plan changed. And hopefully you all know that. That's kind of pretty standard. But if I take the same table and I put some data in there and I gather the stats, and then I just add some data to the end, but don't regather the stats. So we've got a table. This is the data set that's in there. It's about 10 days worth of data. And the stats are just there for the first 3 days. And I do a query for today. I'm setting the date to December 25th. And I do a straight query. Now this query is not going to change. It does that. We do a table access full, we get a cost of 13. I'm now going to move the day on. It's now the 26th of December. We do exactly the same SQL. We get the same output, table access full, cost of 13. We move the day on again, and exactly the same SQL, and we've got a different plan. We haven't changed any of the statistics. We haven't done anything, but the plan changed. So now we've got a cost of 10. If we move the date on again for 28th, the cost's now dropped down to 2. So the plan has changed, you know, from what it was previously. Why has it changed? Well, if we look in DBA tab columns, Oracle records the high and low value associated with any column. And if you send a query to the optimizer that is outside of this range, it will employ what's called a statistical decay. And what it says is, you've told me the highest value in your table is the 26th of December. It's less likely that there is data there on the 27th of December. Even less likely there's data there on the 28th of and 29th. And so as soon as you get further away from your highest recorded date, the cost gets automatically reduced by Oracle. So, your plans can change when you add data and change your stats, and your plans can change when you add data and don't change your stats. So let's try with no stats. It's actually harder to do